First of all, there is a leadership shortage globally for leaders and organizations in every industry, every country. And the problem is that this has gotten more and more severe. And why is that? Well, leaders used to stay a much longer time in organizations, but environments are changing so rapidly that organizations exist in. The kind of leadership that worked like last year, new things are required. The second is that leadership is extraordinarily stressful. So if there are people out there who are leaders, they know what I'm talking about. I have that experience myself in multiple leadership roles. And so when we're under stress, and it can be severe when you're in leadership, of course, the Enneagram is really important in helping leaders reduce stress and to kind of be at their better selves under those. The other is, third area is that leadership, leaders have the biggest impact on organizations of any single role. And so when I want to say something interesting that I learned years ago when I first wrote my leadership book, What Type of Leader Are You? And I discussed with Warner Burke, you know, what he thought leadership was. He's an expert in OD and leadership. And he said, actually, it's interesting. Nobody really knows what leadership truly is. That's why there's thousands and thousands of books written about it. I had to laugh, but, you know, it's kind of true. It's like if you look at the history of what leadership is, it really moves with the time. So what is it really that the Enneagram can bring to this? Well, first of all, it's your leadership style. One of the things that I discovered early on when I was writing the What Type of Leader Are You book, is, and it was a hunch, that our leadership style actually grows out of our Enneagram type. So if leaders understand how they have a kind of a natural style that comes from their type, and of course their leadership style has strengths that go with it, and also sort of development areas, or what we call in OD derailers, things that can take you off track, it can actually help leaders recognize what their strengths are and how to use them but not overuse them, and how their potential derailers that are kind of also go with the type, the things they don't pay much attention to because it's not in their leadership kind of paradigm, how they can work on those before they become a problem. That really helps organizations keep their leaders, help leaders be more expansive in their possibilities, and it completely helps them reduce their stress because they're working on these derailers before they become a problem.
So, Ginger, can you give us an example of how you would work with a leader to help them see the ways that they derail and prevent that?
Yes, be happy to. So let's take, for example, an Enneagram Type 7 leader. Okay, and that's on my mind because I just was working last week with a wonderful group of people, leaders, and the leader of leaders was a 7, so it's very topical for me. So their natural leadership style that comes out of their Enneagram type is to get people excited and create innovative ventures so that the organization can take advantage of new and exciting and important business opportunities. So this is a great way of leading, and it creates certain gifts, and it creates derailers. So they're imaginative and creative and curious, and they can get people really excited about a vision, and they think very quickly and come up with lots of ideas. On the other hand, they can create so many ideas that the people who work for them don't know which idea matters most to them and which doesn't. And what I've seen, it's interesting in a lot of 7 leaders who they come up with all these great ideas, and then they wonder why the people who work for them don't come up with great ideas. And what turns out to be is that the leader comes up with so many, the 7 leader, so many ideas, that the people who are working for him or her go, oh my gosh, which of these should I do? And the leader thinks so fast that they go, the people working for them can't quite put the words together as fast. And they go, if I've got these 20 things to do and I don't know which is the most important, if I add my own, then we have 25 things to do, and then I'm really going to feel overwhelmed. So it's an interesting thing that the leader most wants people to come up with ideas and don't want to be the only generator, but their actual behavior paradoxically kind of reduces that in the people who work for them.
Beautiful. So how do you, when you're working with a type 7, because for all of us, these unconscious behaviors can happen so instinctually, how would you actually get a type 7 leader who probably has a lot of energy to change that that behavior? What kind of, do you do exercises with them? Is it just a matter of when they understand it, they use self-observation?
Well, that's, let me ask, I can answer your question, Jessica, in a slightly broader way. So when I'm talking about leadership in general, I'm also talking about there's eight other leadership styles that are equally effective in certain contexts, but also have their pluses and their derailers. So I really think in terms of leadership development, if a seven leader also understands the other eight leadership styles, and they start to go, oh, there's more than just the way I approach this. And if you get a lot of leaders in an organization willing to work on their potential derailers as well as honor their gifts, it's much easier for any single leader to go, oh, well, if this person can work on that, I can work on this. So what I would say, however, that whether it's in the coaching of a seven leader or in leadership development, which is what I'm really talking about, with the seven leader, is like if they really want other people to generate ideas, okay, and that's what they really do want, and then they look at their own behavior and see how it's not their intention, but the impact is it keeps people from generating their own ideas, they will usually make a choice. Do I want to just speak all my own ideas and let them out in a flurry, or do I want to get other people to generate ideas, and maybe I just need to not talk quite so much sometimes? Or I've had some seven leaders who've decided in their team meetings that instead of coming up with the ideas, they will manage the agenda and help other people come up with ideas. So we all make choices, and we all help with conscious choices, and we help each other with that. And so if you have leaders working on their development in a team context, the team can also help the leader kind of readjust. So that's how I would say it's always about choice. It's about awareness, and it's about choice.
I'm really curious, Ginger, because this just sounds like a wonderful way of training in a company. Have you noticed that when the leader and enough of the other people in the company learn this way of the nine ways of leading and the nine derailers, have you noticed an increase in creativity?
I've noticed an increase in capability. Some people, based on their type, might already be pretty creative. So there might be that, but an increase in productivity, an increase in cohesion, an increase in capacity, people getting promoted more easily because they have a bigger bandwidth. See, I also work with them on developing leadership competencies based on their type. So there's some very core competencies like driving for results or striving for self-mastery or knowing the business and thinking and acting strategically. And different leaders based on their type may have certain strengths and also certain development areas that goes with their type. So that also is helpful in terms of helping leaders all over an organization with leadership development. So I see so many benefits to it. Creativity may be one of them, but generally that's not what a seven's needing. They're needing focus, right? Whereas other types might need to kind of break the boundaries and learn to be more expansive.
Yes, I think I was just thinking about it. Maybe what I should have said was co-creativity, like that kind of cooperative creativity.
Yeah, definitely that.